this series on the Brisk Grove, this being number three, during the time of David Soloveitchik's passing, the last son, the last live son of the Brisk Grove, Rav Yitzchak Zev Halevi Soloveitchik, or Velvel, and that's really what inspired us to speak about him. So I want to say something that I heard from actually a Talmud, a friend of mine, Rav Robinson, a Talmud of Rav David, and I think, as I understand it, it really expresses a lot of what Brisk was about. And we were talking about a certain inyan, and he explained to me, you know, in Brisk, the way we view it is that we're not bailim on the Torah. And I remember I was very moved and tremendous clarity. We're not bailim on the Torah. What does a baal mean? There are things that I own that are mine to change, right? There's a recipe. I adopt the recipe. I want a little extra salt, a little extra sugar, something tart, make the cake a little fluffier. That's my business. I have a house. I can rearrange the furniture. I can gut it and put new tiles down. I do it my way. It's my car. I can sell it, buy another car. I'm a baalim on that. When you're a baal on something, baal means owner. When you're a controller on something, it's yours to change. So in Brisk, they emphasized that we're not baalim on the Torah. The Torah isn't ours to change. Sometimes we perceive their problems, their issues, fair problems, fair issues. What do? Oh, maybe we could use this heter, maybe we could use that heter, we could do this thing. But when it breaks down, sometimes it breaks down to the fact that there's an underlying belief that you think that you're in control of the Torah. And if you see there's a problem, albeit with good intention, it's your Torah to change. But in Brisk, they always stood like a wall and said, you know what? We're not bailim on the Torah. The Torah is not ours to change. And even if there are problems and even if there are issues and we don't always know how to deal with every issue and how to deal with every problem. I hear people tell me sometimes, you know, we need a solution for this issue. Guess what? Not every issue has a solution which is tenable or viable. You know why? Because we're not bailim on the Torah. I can't control the Torah. It's not my Torah to change. If it was my Torah to change, we could change it, right? But it's not my Torah to change. We're not bailim on the Torah. And I remember that when I heard that probably about 10 years ago or so. It gave me a lot of clarity in my own life and perception and hashkafa. And it's something that obviously that was Reb David straight from the source, from the great Brisk Rav. And I think it's a very meaningful hashkafa, very hashkafa which has to be thought about. And it's nuanced and explains things in a good way. It's not that issues aren't issues, not that problems aren't problems. It's not that things have to be ignored, but there is a wall, there is a boundary for what we can do as Torah Jews, as traditional Jews, and there's a wall of things we can't do, right? We have to know when we can be makel, when we can't be makel. It's a mitzvah often to be lenient and to allow certain things, but the things that are can't be, that's the wall of the Torah, and we're not baalim, we're not controllers of the Torah to go past what the Torah allows us to do.